Good day. This is Michael Sullivan from DSP. I am going to walk you through a pretty simple thing today, how to create a saved search and then create a custom KPI out of that. I've been at DSP now for about 2 years, but I was at NetSuite Direct for 8 years. And then I worked at a couple other software companies over the last 25 years, focusing on manufacturing and distribution. And the topic, safe search that creates a custom KPI. And we know that NetSuite, you know, delivers about 20 or 30 of these, but wouldn't it be great if you could create your own? And it's pretty easy. So let me go into NetSuite and we'll really start from the basics. Go reports, new search. So I'm going to go look at a transaction. And so I have to scroll a lot to get down to the transaction ones. I am going to look at all sales orders that have an item categorized as cookware in it. I'll just call it KPI, cookware. All right, so you don't really need all of these little checkboxes. I like it because I can put this thing as a reminder, and if I want to use it later on in a dashboard or as a list view, I can do that. Under type, I'm going to pick sales order. That's my first criteria here. Then what I'm going to do is look at mainline. So mainline means, am I looking at the header or the lines? And I'm going to say, no. So I want to look at the line level of the actual data, which means it's like the items. Then I am going to go down and I'm going to find the item table under item fields. I know it's a lot of scrolling because there's a lot of stuff happening. And I have a field called item type one that I always create myself. So this is a custom field you can see, and I'm gonna say it starts with cookware. All right. So that kind of covers my criteria. I got a sales order. I'm gonna look at the, not the header, but I'm gonna look at the lines. I'm gonna take that item field, but I'm gonna clean up a whole bunch of stuff. And I have a lot of custom fields here, and that's the reason they show up, is once you create a custom field and you say show on list, they automatically become available for all saved searches and all reports. So that's the benefit. You don't have to do anything, but if you're like me and you create all these things, then you need to at some point in time clean them up. All right, but what we're going to do is we're going to add the item in there by just typing item. We'll go to quantity. We already have the amount here, so that's good. Now, just to make sure, I'm going to go back to the item table here. And I'm going to, again, grab that, and I'm going to put the item type one field here, right? So we can make sure that that's actually clear. I'm going to sort it just by date. That's what I want to do. So I'm almost done here, but I got a couple of things I need to do. I need to filter by a date field. So this is how the key performance indicator knows what month, what week, what year I'm in. So it has to be date field that you use that's available. It could be the ship date too. The other thing is, in order to create a total, I need a sum field. So I'm going to sum on the amount. So think what I've got. I am looking at only items with cookware. I am going to look at the dollar total and I'm going to filter it by date. So when I do save and run here, note, here's my amount, $2,468. Now I'm going to go back up to my dashboard. I want to go look at my portlet here. There's these little rectangular boxes that are on your dashboard. That's what we like to call them portlets. I'm going to go to setup. going to add. All right, there's mine. I just hit that. I hit done. Now at the bottom here, now I can compare various date ranges, so month, quarter, year, whatever you want, just a drop down. If I wanted to highlight, then I would say, yes, I want it to highlight. If I want it to show up on the top here, you can see over here, then I would headline this. So it's, if I want to headline only at a certain value, then I would put something in here. And then if I want to do a comparison month to month, then I would click here. And again, I'm comparing this month versus last month. I'm going to just do, because I may not have a lot of data here. I might do like last year. So once I save this, add it to the bottom here. You can see we have API sales by cookware. We didn't have much this month, but we look us here. Now, when I click on this here and I just hit the control key, it opens up in a new tab. I can see here's all my orders that made that up. All right, here we can see the item type was cookware. And we can see here was the products that we sold. All right, if we go return back to summary, there's that total. And there's that total on the dashboard. All right, so by creating that saved search, grouping it and summing it, we basically have our brand new own key performance indicator.